Oh. Aww.
What was it?
Love. Compassion.
Wait, and I was just clapping my hands.
Victoria and love.
Victoria and love.
Okay, fun fact. Mm-hmm. Before we were frequency broads and we were brainstorming names, we giggly laughed for hours at the name The Portal.
Yeah. The Portal.
The Portal. But, I mean, it's already taken by another man, so thankfully frequency broads came to be and it resonates with us way more.
Mm-hmm. Although we are a portal.
Oh, yeah.
Are we not? Oh. If you have not watched our last week's episode on frequency, we are hopping right here to this episode on portals. I talked about the last episode that they're internal and external, and I know Victoria got a lot of downloads for that this evening. Girl, I'm very excited because portals be portaling, you know?
I was jotting down all the ways in which we see portals in the inner world and outer world. Pick one. What does that sound? You hear that?
Or is it the microdose setting?
How do we both hear it at the same time? They're like, oh, you said you're a portal and we just opened up one. Dun, dun, dun.
Might I also state for anyone around us, we are talking about portals. We are not looking to necessarily open a portal right now.
No, we're not.
So we are just talking about it. Continue, girl.
Okay. In the outer world, portals. Wait. Do we want a freak check?
Well, how I'm feeling right now is I'm feeling great. We just did our episode on frequency minutes ago, and I think that I got a lot of downloads for that one, and I'm really eager to see what comes through for portals. How are you feeling? Why are you looking at me like that?
Because I keep hearing the music again. It's like a mix between a jazz station and an ice cream truck.
Yeah. You know what? Walk through the fog, girl.
Truly. But there better be some ice cream. I feel good. Portals is something that is near and dear to my heart, having experienced them since I was a little girl, not mm-hmm. really knowing or having the vocabulary to describe what mm-hmm. I was experiencing. I've always had a thing with mirrors. I had a giant mirror in my childhood bedroom, and it opened up so much. So many entities came through, and it was sort of this hot spot. And I'm grateful to be at this point in my life, in my evolution, to know how to protect myself and how to really play and harness the energy that can be just amplified with mirrors. And so when I was kind of just thinking through all the ways we experience portals in our outer world, mirrors, of course, was top of mind. Black holes.
Ooh.
I know. Black holes
are love such a black holes.
Black holes, I think, are super cool because the law of physics or laws of physics don't exist. Mm-hmm. And I think it's really hard for our minds to conceptualize because we are so used to operating in like gravity and like what goes up must come down, but not in a black hole.
And what I love about that too is it's almost like, right, most people have a hard time thinking about these concepts of frequency or portals or other dimensional beings because that's not something that is in our science books necessarily.
Not yet.
Not yet. But black holes are something that are like, it's as if like the field is leaking out. You know, it's like, we'll give you a little bit because we're leaking out of this little portal right here. Mm-hmm. And we get to see it and it confuses us and it excites us and we have theories, but we're not sure because it's so different from what we know. So I love black holes.
Symbols. Ooh. We see symbols all the time, whether they be in numbers or shapes. Yeah, symbols can be portals.
Mm. You know, I think with that one, it makes me want to ask the question for everyone. What is a portal? Right? Because we're talking black hole. That seems easy to make the connection, but then you say symbols, and that's a little bit harder. So for you, what does a portal mean?
A portal is an access point to another reality, a different dimension. It can be even a new perspective, which is ultimately a new reality.
Mm-hmm.
It can be big or small, simple or drastic. It really is, I think, a tool at the end of the day.
Mm. So just to reiterate, there are some doorways, portals that are doorways, like you were saying, your mirrors, where entities are coming in.
Yeah.
But there are also portals that are just, well, I guess it all is, right? That's what the whole last episode was. Energy coming in. Energy that's malleable for you to create a different perspective, for you to hop into a different timeline.
Right. So these are more so portals in the outer world that influence the portals in your inner world.
Mm. Okay, before you get to that, keep going on the outer portals. I like that.
Okay, okay. Mandalas.
Mm.
Similar to symbols, right? It is something that you can use in a meditation practice to stare into. And I, like, very complex geometric patterns were always something I experienced when I would sleepwalk as a child. It'd be this overlay of geometric patterns. So mandalas, when I look at them in my meditation practice, it very much takes me back to my, like, galactic sleepwalking childhood days. I think where I was kind of teetering between, I had one foot in this world, one foot in the intergalactics.
In another world.
Totally. And it was sort of this wild ride of experiencing both at the same time.
Mm.
And it was around the age where we, you know, really sink our entire soul into our bodies. And I feel like that was me kind of going back and forth and playing with the other side, even though it's not another side, it's it's a portal.
It's everywhere. If you think, the way that I think of these portals too is like when we talked about frequency, right? Everything emits a frequency, and we've talked about it before that each wavelength of frequency is a timeline, is a reality, is a dimension for you to step into, and they're all layered on top of each other. So all you're doing is either finding an access point of a frequency shift enough for it to crack in between, or as you're saying with mandalas, like creating that, whether you're staring at it, you can draw one. I actually saw this person the other day. She was channeling and she used 33 stones to make three circles interlocking. And that was the Sirian portal. Or 33 for each circle. I'm sorry. You can construct these external portals.
Yeah, like a labyrinth.
Mm-hmm. Oh, a labyrinth for sure.
Yeah.
Or even Stonehenge. Your altar.
Oh, for sure.
Setting up your altar and having the energy flow, right? What we have here is, and we'll get more into this in a little bit, but is like the chakras with a cosmic and an earth crystal as well. We have a little, hold on, I'm going to get closer. A little jar of another dimension and a symbol with the palm and a portal in the middle. This right here is creating an energy frequency or circuit that wasn't in this space before. That could be used as a portal. It could be used as malleable energy to do something here, or it could be used as a doorway to access different kinds of energies or beings or spaces.
Our eyes. One of my favorite portals. So in Tantra, we practice eye gazing.
Mm.
And it really, I mean, what's the saying? Like, it's the gateway to your soul.
Mm-hmm. Mm-hmm.
This bitch has the biggest fucking pupils you'll ever see in your life. Like,
no, not for real.
Sober. Sober. Yeah. And I swear it's because you just have so much soul vitality and you're not afraid to show your soul.
Wow.
And that's why reptilians have little slivers. Probably because they don't have much of a soul to begin with, but then they don't want to show their soul.
Whoa. You're driving me crazy right now. My fucking pupils are so big. If I got closer, you wouldn't be able to tell because there's a fucking light behind it. But at like age fucking 10, my mom was like, I'm drug testing you. I was like, no, I literally don't even know what a drug is. She's like, why are your pupils so big?
Well, and especially when Tara gets really excited, they get huge.
You like barely see that my eyes are blue.
Mm-hmm.
They're just black.
Galactic baby. You're Wait, really.
Hold on. Can you talk more about eye gazing, though?
Yeah. Oh, eye gazing. Well, even let's just talk about eye contact, because we've mentioned before this exchange of files of DNA information that happens through the eyes. And whether or not you make eye contact or not, oftentimes you are having some sort of energetic exchange. But when you exchange eye contact, it is a more direct transfer of DNA information, of your frequency imprinting on someone else's frequency. And I think for some people, it's really, really hard when you're going through your awakening to make eye contact. Or if you're in certain times during your cycle, you just don't want to be seen. And it's total. I mean, I just, I like to hide my eyes sometimes. I love me some sunglasses at night.
I love me some sunglasses only because I, now that I'm thinking more about the eyes too, like in my eyes particularly, I cannot not stare at people in the eye.
Oh, yeah. So,
and I'll like I'm on the bus, you know, and I'm like looking around. And I'll just like stare into somebody's eyes and then they look at me and I'm still holding it. And they're like, and I'm like, we are locking in. But it's so crazy to think of it that way because just as I said, portals are just that little crack in dimensions for you to access either malleable energy or information. So looking into someone's eyes, I know there it is. All I'm doing is, ooh, I kind of felt gross. Like I just like
that moved, was really gross.
Moved your eye to the side and grabbed the knowledge and then threw it back in mine, you know?
I don't like going to the eye doctor, I think, for that reason.
I've never been to the eye doctor. What? You don't have to go to the eye doctor.
I know. It's just wild to be.
I was like, am I supposed to be going to the eye doctor?
No, I've just been going for like 20 plus years of my life. So
yeah.
Well, when you have glasses. Much longer than that.
Like, little baby girl with her glasses. You know why? Because they weren't ready for your portal, bitch.
Also, I like to read books at night or in the dark. So that could have exponentially, who knows? I have a really cute photo I found recently. I've been doing some like inner child work or just like looking at photos of me when I had joy before all the trauma really set in and just looking at that part of me, even being aware of the part of me that didn't fully have like all of my soul and all of my vitality in my body and looking at like how absent I looked. While I didn't have a lot of trauma, I still didn't have all my soul in me. So it's a very fascinating observation.
Wait, speaking of eyes, I also just watched this video of someone who has, my dyslexia, is it DDI or DID? I think it's DDI.
I don't know what that is.
Basically multiple personality. It's like dissociative identity disorder, DID. And this person happened to shift into a different personality on camera, you actually see their eye color change and their eyes like gloss over and then they kind of shift and then the next person drops in and it's that portal, right? There you go. You're accessing that fucking portal and letting this other sliver of you or, you know, I don't know too much about it, but I just saw that video and saw the eye change and I was like, wow. So it's interesting to kind of compare it to what we got going on here.
The eyes, Chico, they never lie. Eye gazing in Tantra is a really such a deep, it's very intimate to practice with your partner or a friend even, and it is so uncomfortable. I mean, think about if you've practiced yoga, holding a posture for a little longer than maybe you want to and like fighting that that voice in your mind that's saying like, get me out of this. This sucks. It hurts. I don't want to do this any longer. When you're face to face with someone you love and you're exchanging eye contact and it's really uncomfortable, having the support of their eyes to keep the gaze locked is so potent. And when two people are focused on the same thing, it just amplifies whatever it is. If whether or not you have an intention or not, there's still love being transferred between the two of you. And it's a really great way if you are feeling like you want to open the portal of vulnerability between you and your partner, you and your friend. Eye gazing is a really good way to start even perhaps a difficult conversation where you want to open your heart and yet you know your heart is feeling so guarded. And so you could sit there, you could have your hand on your heart, you could even have your hand on each other's hearts. It's really, have you and Andrew ever tried it?
Yeah, we have.
Yeah.
Not like in difficult conversation, just like in practice, like, okay, we're going to sit cross leg, knee to knee, just looking into each other's eyes. It even with us, like it is hard, right? Because you want to look away or you want not even look away. You want to ask a question or you want to engage in some way and you have to stop yourself and just be like, no, exist, be present, be mindful of what is coming through the portal. You do not need to speak it out because he's getting, and I think that's the thing with eye gazing is we forget that it's two ways. So I sat there and I was like, oh, now I'm thinking about this. And now I'm getting this information. Or now I just had this realization. I want to tell him. But that's taking away from the information he's gaining out of my portals.
Yeah.
Because he's having the same experience I am, just with different information.
Well, speaking of your portals, shall we switch to the inner portals?
Yes, please.
I mean, of course, the first one I want to talk about is the yoni and the womb. The womb, I mean, before we get into that, because I want that to be maybe a little deeper dive of a conversation, some other inner portals are chakras, which, as you can see here, the stones laid out represent the chakras, and they are energy centers, aka portals. Literally every cell of your being is a portal, if you think about it.
Yeah. I mean, if you look at, there's the whole concept behind the electron, the one electron that we all share or other lifetimes share, and that in itself is a portal. Anything can become a portal. Like I said in the last episode, there are portals that we create physically, boom, through eye gazing, boom, through whatever. There are portals that are here on Earth already, certain areas, whether it was constructed long ago, like Stonehenge or the pyramids, or whether it's physical land. Like, I swear to God, the Oregon coast is a fucking portal and a half. I'll tell you that.
It is. Yeah. It feels more like an exit point, though.
Yes. Yes. Although there is the concept that the energy comes in the Pacific Northwest, crosses down to like the Florida area and then back up.
No, I totally agree that the energy is coming down in the Pacific Northwest. But there's still something about the,
there's an exit there. And then, you know, as I mentioned last episode, and as we all experienced with Lionsgate Portal, there are portals that open up because the energy from either the cosmos or inner Earth is just like until it erodes and makes that little sliver of crack. So it's about either creating or utilizing the portals that already exist, going and traveling the world and being like, I'm going to sit in this vortex in Sedona and use that energy.
The Earth has chakras.
Yes.
Yeah. Mm. Also, I just want to like reiterate the power of people coming together with the same intention. And 88 Lionsgate is such a good example.
888 this year.
Is it?
Yeah, it is.
Yeah. I personally am super annoyed hearing all this 888 Lionsgate talk on Instagram, but it just shows the power of intention and when everyone is focused on the same thing. So can we all in unity come together focusing on, well,
Peace. Unity.
Not what we don't want, but what we do want.
Yes. Because that portal is malleable energy. It's not like, oh, I'm going to take your request. It's you saying, I'm going to use the frequency of thought and emotion to create something. So if you're like, I don't want this to happen, that energy doesn't understand that, because that energy is only creating. It only creates. It doesn't destroy. So if you have that malleable energy from the portal of Lion's Gate, or from going to the vortex in Sedona, or from creating an altar, and you go, I don't want this. They're like, all I'm hearing is this part, that I have to create this, right? So taking away from what I don't want and thinking about what I do want in my current reality.
I guess I want to touch on love for a moment.
Mm.
And that love is really this pure life force energy.
Mm.
And love has been so misconstrued in my lifetime, at least. And I feel like I've really just come to this awakening and realization of what the truth of the meaning of love means.
Mm.
And I've been looking at it as life force energy. So who do I love? Instead of focusing on who I don't love so much, who do I love? Sending them more of my life force energy.
Mm. And if you think of the heart chakra being a portal, all you're doing is taking that life force energy and filtering it out now.
Mm-hmm.
Having that be your emitting frequency. Mm-hmm. Because these portals inside us, and I'm pretty sure in season one we talk a little bit more about the chakras. Maybe. Google it. But each one is a portal for you to tap into stored emotion that needs to be metabolized, for you to tap into lineage that you've been holding in your epigenetics, for you to tap into other parallel lifetimes. Like, these are the portals, and each has a very specific theme, let's say, in that portal, that mm-hmm. frequency signature within that portal of, you know, your throat chakra being your truth and your voice. So it's emitting that theme no matter what, whether it's one that's like we shut off our voice or one that's like we speak too much. It doesn't matter. It's still going to be emitting. It's still an access point for that.
Well, speaking of access points, and if we're, you know, talking about polarity, the throat, the opposite of the throat is the yoni. I actually wrote down this masculine, feminine, right? So just getting you thinking about polarity for a second, and not in a way of like separation, but more in a yin yang, what balances out, like north node, south node, solar, lunar, crown, throne, heart, root, or head, not heart. Throat and yoni, which they look very similar anatomically speaking. And then the heart and the womb. And the womb is, I mean, the place of all creation, whether you're creating life via babies or your creative life force energy, because your second chakra is that of your creative energy. So the void is really the birthplace of all creation. It is a blank canvas for you to go in and create whatever you want. And I think that it's really important, if you're wanting to go down that path, understanding the power of the yoni. And there are so many amazing practices for you to explore, one of them being oming, orgasmic meditation. It's been around for a while now, and it is so much fun to practice with a partner. So you need someone else for it, sorry, as much as I love celibate life. But you lie on your back and your partner is seated next to you, upright, and you have your legs sort of intertwined, and he, she, they takes their finger and ever so gently like barely touching, just hovering over your clit for 15 minutes minimum. You start to feel, they start to feel this electrical current and the power in this energy center. And so it's such a good way to play with energy and leverage our energetic bodies in a way where we are currents. And what, I mean, what more fun way than to explore there?
I have not done that.
Okay, let's chat about it later.
Okay. I thought you were going to talk about, and I think we've talked about it before in our sacred sex episode, one of the sex episodes that we've had. Check them out.
Yeah, we hear you really like our sex episode. Should we have more?
Let us know. But you talk about, like, I believe, or maybe this was on the side, setting an intention, like, while you climax and being like, oh, using that orgasm energy as a portal to create the next reality, to create the next whatever. Was that, did you say that on the pod?
I did.
Yeah. Because I did that once. Well, multiple times.
Did you manifest money?
I did. Yeah. I told you about that, right? I don't Maybe. Think I said it on there.
I mean, I like sex and money. We got that Scorpio placement, sex and of course.
Money. With the,
yeah.
And at the time, the first time I did it, I don't know. Apologies if I said this story already, but I didn't tell Andrew that I was doing it. So I'm like coming to the end and I'm like, money, money, money. And he's like, what? I'm like, nothing. Money, money, money comes to me freely. I'm like, money. It fucking works, man. Portal, portal energy. Okay, so the one last thing that I want to share, it's a little bit about frequency, a little bit about portals. I had asked during this download session, what does the collective need to know about frequency? Forgot to share that in the last episode, even though I said enough. And what does the collective need to know about portals? This is their message for you. Okay, so I'm pretty sure we might have talked about it before or maybe in our freak check, but right now, especially after the Lionsgate portal, there is new fields of love and intimacy that are being downloaded into Earth's grid. It is our job to lay that grid line out. But you can only do it with the most updated processing system, which means you need to be taking care of yourself. You need to be living authentically, realigning your frequency, right? Because then that shit comes... All your chakras, all your inner portals are running clear. So when that comes in or up, whatever, you get that information. You go, great. Now I'm able to anchor this in. There's no hooks in my belt holding me back. I'm ready to go. And they were also talking about duality, talking about how when there's a new frequency of love and unity entering our sphere, then that means there's going to be a duality equal to that in darkness, which means that it's just going to get even harder to hold that light, but it's still super necessary. We live in a duality space. We're going, if there's that much darkness, the way that they want us to look at it is if we sit there and we're like, but life is shitty and chaos and what's going on in the world and this with, you know, global news and national news. If it's that fucking bad, that means it could be that fucking good.
Yes.
That's what they want you to anchor in. If it's that dark and shitty and evil, I hate using the word evil. If it's that dark and shitty and uncomfortable, then it could be just as much light, unity, and love. We just need to anchor that while this is anchoring in because it's a duality. We just need to choose what side we're sitting on at the moment, which hopefully... As you were mentioning, like all of us having the intention on one thing, let it be the light that's in the darkness. Oh, and then the last thing they said, that was mostly about frequency, but the last thing that they said about portals was stop procrastinating and get fucking busy. They were like, clean your inner portals now, like yesterday, because there's too much work to be done. Find out your assignment and fucking show up for class, bitch, because there is so much anchoring, and it doesn't need to be work. It doesn't need to be hard. It just needs to be authentic, innocent, joy. Like, these are things that we can find. I mean, fuck yeah, because of our programming, we get shut down, we get judgmental, but like, work through those inner portals so we don't have that anymore. Creation, like, I was like, what goddess can help us through this time? And they were like, creative spark. She's the one, that creation with intention for creating something new or something that you love as opposed to what you don't. That's what
we're doing. Wait, there's a goddess creation spark?
No, I forgot her name.
Oh. I was like,
well, hold on. Let's be honest. It's not that I forgot her name. It's just, I don't know how to say her name. Brigid? B-R-I-G-I-D.
Mm-hmm.
Brigid?
I thought it'd be Bridget.
Brigid. Well, goddess of creative spark. She's here with us on Earth right now to really show that that's what takes, right? That darkness. We need that creative spark. Use it as a portal. Use this shit as a portal so that way we can create something new.
If it is pronounced Bridget, how funny is it that, I mean, she's a bridge.
Oh.
Right?
Hold on. But that's really kind of all I have on portals. I mean, you can create portals. You can exist within portals. You have portals within you. Access them. Get the keys of information so you can realign and ground in and get your assignment and do the whole damn thing, you know?
And if you feel like it's too hard to clean your insides before accessing your portals, clean your outsides, clean out your closet.
Remember when she was also trying to clean out her closet for months?
I did it. Now I'm ready for round two.
Catch us here next week. Just remember that there is always an access point for you to find the malleable energy to create something new. Just make sure you have some good intentions.
And so it is.
We love you. Thank you for being here with us. And we are excited to see you again next week.